So you, my God, you know,
sir.
Randy calls me up and he says, you know, I got this photographer. He did a Bon Jovi book. I had a Bon Jovi book. He's like, and he also did the World Series. And he's a baseball. He's got to go cover the World Series. We're trying to get the date right. You've done everything. You're like Johnny Cash. You've been everywhere.
I've done a couple of events over the years. Olympics, Super Bowls, inaugurations, traveled the world with rock bands. It's kind of a fun gig.
Now, how do you, like, do you have to, like, battle for the access to get the shot, or are they pretty much like what's it like when you have to get, when you absolutely positively have to get the shot?
Yeah, sometimes it depends who you're working for, right? So when I'm working for Bon Jovi, I have all access. I can go everywhere, I can go anywhere I want, I can push security guards out of the way. It's kind of kind of a wonderful thing. But when I'm working as a member of the press, like even Sports Illustrated at the Super Bowl, people think, oh, you can just go wherever you want, but you're still limited as to where you can go. And there are times when you see that picture at the other end of the field and you got to get down there, and there's always a security guard standing in your way, and yeah, I've gotten a little testy with them a couple of times, but so you do what you got to do, you know.
So like with Bon Jovi, you're at the top, and you can do anything you want. With the other guys, you're like persona non grata.
Yeah,
oh, he's a photographer. He's a pain in the ass. Get him out of here.
Pretty much. Yeah. No, when I've got that all access pass on, I can pretty much go anywhere. I'll be at a stadium in Vienna, and the sun is setting, and I'll say, oh, it might make a nice picture up there, and I'll walk into production, and I'll say, hey, I need to go to the roof, and they say, okay, somebody take Bergman to the roof, and they take me right
up. Look at you!
So, yeah, that was kind of a nice thing. As a photographer, that's the ultimate, to just have that kind of access.
You're going
to
be at Derek Jeter's last game tomorrow night.
I am, yeah, hopefully. I'm doing, hopefully, if it doesn't, if we don't have a rain out. Yeah, I'm doing a GigaPan,
right,
which are these super wide, high-resolution panoramic images that I do. I did one at Obama's first inauguration, and it went crazy. It got 20 million views, and it went insane. Yeah, basically, I take multiple overlapping images and then I stitch them together into one giant photo, so you can zoom in on every face in the crowd pretty much. So I've done this since the inauguration. I've done them at World Series and Olympics and Super Bowls, and people go crazy for them, because if you're there, you can prove, you know, everybody always says, oh, I was at that game, you know, and like 100,000 people say they were there and the stadium only holds 40. But now you can go ahead and prove it. So I'm doing one for Sports Illustrated tomorrow night at Jeter's last home game, and then I'm doing one for MLB.com on Sunday in Boston for Jeter's last game.
Now, did you ever, you must have met a lot of players, you got a lot of friends that are baseball players, like they hire you on the side, they say, Dave, come here.
Yeah, that doesn't really happen so much.
Shoot my bar mitzvah, I mean.
Yeah, I've done the occasional gig like that, but most of the time, when you're working for the press, it's kind of a separate thing where you don't get that.
Oh, you don't solicit. You don't.
Yeah,
do that,
you
right?
don't really do that.
Now, how did Works come to be? Bon Jovi Works. It's an incredible book. You've got pictures, and they even took pictures themselves for the book because you got lazy at the end and you said,
exactly.
You know what? I'm a rock star now. I don't need this.
John, you take over. I'll sing, and you can shoot a little bit. Yeah, no, I've been the band's tour photographer since 2010, the beginning of 2010, and I was shooting every show already. So last year, I think it was 102 shows on 6 continents last year alone.
Wow.
Yeah, it was pretty insane. And I was I got to travel with the band on the private jet every day.
And get paid.
And get paid, yeah.
Damn.
Sometimes I'd look around and I go, wait a minute, you're paying me too? Okay, well, I'll take it. So that was amazing. We started talking about doing a book really a few years ago, but they had done a book a number of years earlier and, other kinds of, books they've done. So it wasn't quite the right time. But at the end of this run, we really came together and said, now's the time. I mean, I've got such a collection of images now. I shot almost 800,000 frames over the course of 4 years. So,
oh my God.
Yeah, so there's a lot of pictures to go through. But we finally decided to go ahead and put it together into a big book, and we made this giant coffee table book. It weighs a ton.
You get a bicep lift in this book.
Exactly.
The book is unbelievable.
Exactly.
You should put legs on it.
I should.
Like Kramer.
Kramer, yeah. It can be a coffee table itself. So, so it was just a matter of sort of culling it down and figuring out what the theme is and why we're doing it. And John really came up with the title Work. And it has to do with the band's work ethic. And I mean, you know how hard they work and how they've done it for 30 years and stayed at that level and stayed relevant. And it's really amazing to watch. So we've got different chapters, work ethic, hard work, those kinds of things. This ain't work. Where, the off stage stuff, some of the behind the scenes stuff. And yeah, it's really an unfettered look at the band through my eyes. And then, as you mentioned, John, he's got a pretty good eye, right? He's very creative, obviously. He's an
artistic
guy.
You would figure he would be.
Absolutely. Yeah. But the technical stuff, he didn't really know. Shutter speeds and apertures and those kind of things. So we'd be together so often, and he would look over at me and say, hey, what are you doing there? And how does that work? And so I started teaching him. I do photo workshops occasionally. So he became my highest profile photo student. And we'd go out in the park in the middle of, you know, in Zurich and walk around and take pictures. And I'd be giving him photo lessons. So in the book, we've got a section of pictures. Actually, he gives me a hard time because his section of pictures is a lot smaller than mine. Uh-huh. But there's a picture, a bunch of pictures of his family, you know, him on vacation, those kinds of things.
The stuff they wouldn't let you in on.
Exactly. Right?
Then you got wait outside.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen, I want to make a topic out of this. So 1-800-283-101.5. I want to know from you, what is the best rock photo you have or taken? What's the best rock photo you've ever had or have taken? 1-800-283-101.5. I got Dave Bergman, the new book. It's called Bonjovi Work. And it's an incredible book, and you've got to get it. And I got David Bergman, the man who put the book together, the man who shot all the shots. What is the best picture that you, like, in the book? What's your favorite picture in the book? What's the one that has the story behind it for you?
You know, first of all, that song sounds vaguely familiar. Have I heard
Yeah,
that?
Really?
It's
not enough, right?
Can't quite. It's on the tip of my tongue.
In several different languages.
Exactly. Yeah, you know, the book, you know, picking one picture is like picking your children, right? But I got to say, the proudest
Now pictures, it's Sophie's Choice.
Exactly. I'm the most proud of, there's a section in the book called Work Ethic, and it's John actually tore the meniscus in his left knee during a show in Helsinki. And this was in 2011, and not only did he not come off stage, he played another 70 minutes, finished the entire show. I don't know about you, but if I tore my meniscus, I'd be on the ground calling an ambulance, and that'd be it. I'd be done.
A lot of drugs at the show?
No, come on now. These guys are adults. That doesn't happen anymore.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. I don't know. You tell me the guy went 70 minutes, I'd be thinking lead free amicus.
He's not going to leave the stage, right?
So no, he adrenaline.
Came off, exactly. So he comes off afterward, and I'm documenting this whole thing. I mean, I have a journalism background, so I'm just shooting, right? And then you figure it out later if you're going to put the pictures out or what you're going to do with it, but you just got to shoot it. So I documented the whole thing, and afterward he came off and they sent everybody back. The band all went back to the hotel and management left, and it was just in the room with him and his doctor and me, and they were working on his knee, and it was tense. I mean, we weren't sure if this was the end of his career or what's going to happen. So over the course of the next couple of weeks, turned out it was a meniscus tear, and he had rehab. He had acupuncture in his hotel room, and I documented all this. I was in his room when he, you know, gets out of bed, and he's got crutches and the whole thing. And then 2 weeks later, by the way, also didn't cancel a single show.
No.
Two more weeks of shows. And then we had a week off in Ireland, and he had surgery on it. I was in the operating room wearing scrubs, the whole thing, in the operating room while they took the meniscus out of John Bonjovi's left knee. I know. We actually had a picture in there.
You sold it on eBay.
Yeah, right? I do have a picture of it. I had a picture in there in one of the first edits of him actually on the gurney and like his eyes taped closed and the thing is, and we kind of decided that wasn't really, he didn't want his kids to see that and didn't really want that out there. So fair enough. So we went with a little softer picture of that, but it was really, it's funny, the nurses would ask while we were there, they would say, why do you have a photographer here? What are you going to do with these pictures? And he'd say, they'll do a book after I'm dead. You know, they'll put these pictures out in a long time. And then he came back a week later, didn't cancel a single show, and was back on stage in Istanbul almost 100%. So we, when we started putting together the book, I went to him. I said, John, this is the time to do it. I mean, this is the story. This is work. This is
why you can still walk.
Exactly, right? And I love it because he's a kind of guy that gets it. He really understands the value. He knows.
Oh, he understands.
He
the
knows
value, yeah.
The power that he has and the influence he has over people. And he said, he looked at me and he said, you know what? If this influences one kid, if this inspires one kid to work through the pain and come back from an injury better than before, then it's worth it. And so he really let us
sounds like the end of the Babe Ruth story.
I know, right?
You can do it. The first one, not the one with John Goodman.
Exactly. So, yeah, okay. So he really gets it, and I'm really glad that he let us put those in the book.